What's going on, everyone, and welcome to Movie Emporia's new review of Half Brothers, the newest film from director Luke Greenfield. Now, before we begin, hey, if you like my channel, awesome. Hit the subscribe button to join Movie Emporium. Hit that notification bell at the top to find what's coming next. If you like this video, awesome. Hit that like button and comment below on any video to watch, including this one. So this story, Half Brothers, he's a character named Renato. He is an individual from Mexico who basically, as a kid, his father left him and it made him very bitter and angry, but it also made him very successful as an individual while he's getting married to a young woman who has a kid. And because his father did what he did to him, he's kind of not a good father figure to this young boy. And the woman is starting to worry that he's not going to be a good father. It becomes a big problem. And in the process, this character Renato learns his father is up in America, has a new wife and a kid, and he has to travel up there because his father is dying. And this is where we meet Asher. And basically the father tasks Asher and Renato to go on one last trip to kind of fulfill his last will and testament. And so it turns into like an odd couple style story where we have Asher, who's like this free willing, over the top and overzealous and does everything off the cuff and stuff like that. And then you have Renato, who's a very upkempt. He has the buttoned up shirts, the suit jackets, is very kind of stick up his butt type of character. And so these two characters have to learn to not only deal with one another, but in the course of these odd couple style movies, kind of change who they are for the better and so on and so forth. So with the synopsis kind of out of the way, we all know we've never heard of this movie before. It's a movie that kind of threw out its trailer, in the last month or so. It's a movie that I think is either coming to VOD or is going to come to theaters for a couple weeks before it hits VOD. And it has like no name actors in it. It has a couple people that, have done small bits and pieces and so on and so forth. So it's a chance for a director like Luke Greenfield to do an odd couple road trip style movie. And I like Luke Greenfield. I do kind of like The Animal, the Rob Schneider movie, but I really like The Girl Next Door, which of course had Paul Dano, Emile Hirsch, Elijah Cuthbert, and Timothy Olyphant. It was a good film, a fun film for, when it came out. And so I still kind of had hope that even though this movie looked like the billion other films that have come out before it, I was kind of hoping that the whole, take of, two brothers and, director Luke Greenfield kind of putting his own spin on it. But I really just didn't have any hope for this movie. And it's about what I expected. It's very uninspired. It's very trying to be funny. It's not that funny. I chuckled maybe once or twice. The goat is the scene stealer, if you want to call it that, of the movie, because they steal a goat and whatnot. And it's just a movie that is so... It's so copying other movies in such a desperate attempt to be funny that even the main characters on screen, the Asher and Renato, are just not really a great pairing. There's like really no chemistry there. When the inspiring and sad and melodramatic moments happen, they're not really that great to watch. They're very soap opera-ish, especially with the father near the end where there's a video with the father. But it's just a movie that you go in and you're going to watch on cable because there's nothing else on a Saturday afternoon, and you're gonna go, it's not the worst thing in the world. It's not Slender Man or Transformers Revenge of the Fallen, but it's a movie that has its moments where it tries to be a good odd couple road trip movie, but it just I didn't feel anything. I'm never gonna remember this movie a year from now. I'm actually gonna go in my top 10 worst of the films. I'm like, was Half Brothers really that bad? I'm like, no, it was just middle of the road, kind of bland. So, but this, like I said, this review is not going to be too much longer, but it's just it's a movie that just doesn't really have too much heart in it. It just feels like a movie that you would see, Asylum make or something like that. It's kind of a bland, boring, uninspired road trip comedy movie that has an odd couple styling pairing. And, I want to have some kind of feeling for Renato, who has been kind of screwed over most of his life, and Asher, who's trying to make up for the fact of his father leaving him, so like that. And the father's like a terrible person in this movie. He really is. Because they try to make you feel for him, but he's just not one of those characters I had any kind of interest in learning more about. So it's kind of a shame, but it's kind of what I expected from a movie like this. So not really I recommend it. It's just if you see it on cable network or something like that, or free on Netflix. Watch it, but you'll never, that's about it. So, but that's it. That's gonna be my take on Half Brothers. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite Odd Couple road trip movie is. You know, like the Blues Brothers, a very kind of road trippy type movie, so that's always a good one. But anyways, if you like my channel, of course hit the subscribe button to join Movie Emporium, hit that notification bell at the top to find what's coming next. If you like this video, awesome, hit that like button, and we'll see you guys on the next video. Peace out.